Good morning, students. Today we are going to see exercise 5.5. Okay, 5.5 part 2. Already we completed 4 sums, I think so. Okay, so today we are going to start from question number 5. The question is, orthocenter and centroid of the triangle are A of minus 3 comma 5 and B of 3 comma 3 respectively. If C is the circumcenter and AC is the diameter of the circle, then find the radius of the circle. Okay, so here they are giving 3 terms. Okay, what is that? Orthocenter, centroid and circumcenter. Okay, wow. So, first, first, okay, wow. For example, paranga, or a diagram draw pandre. Taking a circle, okay. In this circle, we are drawing one triangle, okay. So, let us a triangle. So we know that centroid. Centroid means it is inside the triangle. Okay, well, centroid is the triangle or median intersect our centroid. Okay, well. So in the centroid being a point of that is B of 3, 3. B point 3, 3. Okay. Then next orthocenter and circumcenter. Okay. Orthocenter na and maybe very good arcana, but circumcenter is the center circle center. Okay. Circle or circumcenter circumcenter go. Gather and put the C in put the gang. Okay. So C point is we don't know. Okay. So we can take it C of A comma B. Okay, then another point that is our orthocenter. Orthocenter is outside of the circle. Number add to go. Okay, orthocenter may be very very well. The kind of white will come. Okay, so the moon may on the empty room, one line will end. Okay, this is our A. A point is minus 3, 5. Okay, so dear much. Okay, now. Another condition is that AC is the diameter of the circle. AC is the length of the circle and the diameter is equal to the circle. Okay, wow. The AC is the line of the circle. The diameter is equal to the circle. Okay. So, okay, wow. So, you can see this in the textbook page number 216. But points are not marked. Okay, wow. So, in the line, la, first A is the orthocenter. A is the orthocenter. Here A is the orthocenter. And B is the centroid. B is the centroid. Orthocenter A. Then centroid B. Okay. Centroid B. Then C is the circumcenter. C is the circumcenter. Okay, this is the circumcenter. Okay, so and another condition is given. What is that? AC is the diameter of the circle. And if we have the diagram, AC is the diameter, but AC is equal to diameter of the circle. Circle or diameter in the work, that is equal to the circle. Okay, and AC is the diameter of the circle. AC is the diameter of the circle. Okay. Then find the radius of the circle. So, it is very important. Okay. The centroid, it is important note. Okay. The centroid divides the centroid divides ortho center and circumcenter. Okay, ortho center and circumcenter internally in the ratio, internally in the ratio two is to one. Okay, va? The ratio 2:1 from the ortho center. Okay, va? From the ortho center. So in the condition use for the number here, say va? Okay. So in the meaning of dina centroid, ortho center line erto dina. Then the ratio lo na namku split pan of dina 2:1 ngra ratio lo split pan. Okay, va? Apon dathle A B ngra part 2 part avum, B C ngra part 1 part ஆவும் இருக்குன்னு அர்த்தம். ஓகேவா? சோ 2:1ங்கற ரேஷியோல ஸ்ப்ளிட் பண்ணோம். இது சென்ட்ராய்டு. ஓகேவா? சரி. ப்ராப்ளம் பார்க்கலாம். இப்போ இதெல்லாம் நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சாதான் நம்ம வந்து சம்ஸ் அங்க யூஸ் பண்ண முடியும். ஓகேவா? சோ லெட் சரி ஓகே. A ortho center. Okay. A is a ortho center. The point is -3,5. Okay. Then B is a centroid. B is a centroid. That is the point is 3,3. Then C point is circumcenter. Okay. The values we don't know, so you can take it C of A comma B. Okay, va? Check. Ipa namakku theriyum, already na solliten. It is in the ratio of ABC, no? It is ABC is the ratio of AB by BC is equal to 2:1. Okay. So therefore, also AB by BC is equal to 2:1. Therefore, B divides AC in the ratio 2:1. Ratio of dale, we can use the suction formula. Okay, so what is the suction formula? Suction formula is by suction formula. By suction formula, P of x comma y is equal to, what is that? Mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, then my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. Okay, wow. So here you can take the points. A point is x1 comma y1. A point is minus 3 comma 5 is x1 y1. Then here B point is the P of x y. Okay, B or point is the one that P of x comma y. Okay, so then C point is A comma B, that is x2 comma y2. Then ratio M is to N is equal to 2:1. Okay, wow. So now we are going to apply the values, that is B of x comma y. B point is 3,3, yeah. So 3,3 is equal to 2a, because mx2, okay, mx2 means m is 2, so 2a minus 3 by 3 comma, then 2b plus 5 by 3, okay, because 2 plus 1, okay. So what do you get? Now you have to split into two parts. Okay, what is that? 2a minus 3 by 3 is equal to 3. Okay, then you can take it cross multiplication. You will get 2a minus 3 is equal to 9. Then 2a is equal to 9 plus 3. Then 2a is equal to 12, therefore a is equal to 12 by 2. If you take cross, can take division, you will get 6. Therefore, a is equal to 6. Okay. Then another value, 2b plus 5 by 3 is equal to 3. Okay. So you can take cross multiplication. 2b plus 5 is equal to 9. So 2b is equal to 9 minus 5. So 2b is equal to 4. Then b is equal to 4 divided by 2. You will get b is equal to 2. Okay. So now we get the points AB. Okay, AB point is what? Here C. Okay, C the C or point the main எடுத்துறோம். A comma B எடுத்துறோம். Okay, well, therefore the circumcenter we found. Okay, therefore circumcenter C point is what? Here 6, 2. Okay, 6, 2. The question already is given. What is that? AC is the diameter. Okay, AC is the diameter. So we want to find the length of AC. Okay, length of AC. Here AC is equal to diameter of circle. Why we are finding this one? Because we want to find the radius of the circle. Radius of the circle, if you want to find, if you find the diameter, from that we can find the radius of the circle. Okay. So what is the A point? So the length of AC. Length of AC is equal to root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay. What is our A point? The A point is minus 3, 5. Okay. Then here C point is 6, 2. Here you can take it x1, y1 and x2, y2. Okay. Therefore, AC is equal to root of x2 minus x1. 6 minus of minus 3, you will get plus 3 whole square. Plus y2 is 2 minus 5 the whole square. Okay. So what do you get? 6 plus 3, 9 whole square. Then 2 minus 5, you will get minus 3. Minus 3 whole square. That is equal to 9 square is 81. Then 3 square is 9. So you will get root 90. Okay. Root 90. So this is diameter. Okay. This is diameter. So diameter is equal to root 90. So what we want to find? Radius, no? Radius of circle. Radius of circle is nothing but diameter by 2. Diameter by 2. That is equal to root 90 by 2. So we can split root 90, no? So how to split? That is 3 into 2 into 5. Okay, 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 into 5, you will get 90 divided by 2. Okay, so for each 3 you can take it 1 3 outside, then into root 2 into root 5 divided by 2. So it can be cancel, no? So you will get 2 root 2, because 2 is equal to what? 2 is equal to root 2 into root 2. Ah? So we can cancel 1 root 2. So what do you get remaining? 3 root 5 divided by root 2. Okay. That is equal to 3 whole root of 5 divided by 2 units. Okay. This is the radius of the circle. Okay. This is very important 5 mark. Okay. Do it carefully. Then next problem, Question number 6. Okay. ABC is a triangle whose vertices are A. ABC is a triangle. Okay. ABC is a triangle. Okay. Then G is the centroid. G is the centroid. G is the centroid. B, D, C, G is a parallelogram. B, D, C, G is a parallelogram. B, D. So we can make one point here. Okay. D. B, D, C, G is a parallelogram. Okay. So B, D, C, G is a parallelogram. Then we can find the coordinate of the vertex of D. So D point we want to find. So D of x comma y we don't know, that only we are going to find. Okay, D of x comma y then we find out. Check. Okay. So what is given? A point is given. Okay. So the A point is 3 comma 4. Then B point is minus 2 comma minus 1. Then C point is 5 comma 3. Then G is the centroid. Okay. Okay. So now we are going to find the centroid. Okay. So centroid G of x comma y is equal to, what is that? Formula is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Okay. Therefore, so what is our x1? This is x1, y1, x2, y2, then x3, y3. Okay. So we can apply the values. Plus 3, x2 is minus 2, x3 is 5 divided by 3, then y1 is plus 4, then y2 is minus 1, y3 is plus 3, whole divided by 3. Okay, that is equal to 5 plus 3, 8, 8 minus 2, you will get 6. Okay, 6 by 3, then 4 plus 3, 7, 7 minus 1, 6. So 6 by 3. So what do you get? The same point, 2 comma 2. Okay. Therefore, centroid G of x comma y is equal to 2 comma 2. Okay. So what we want to prove? We want to find the D of x comma y. D or a point find it for no. But the condition is given. BDCG is a parallelogram. Parallelogram means the condition is opposite sides are equal, or the midpoints, the diagonals may be intersect the same point. Okay, wow. So in here, we have the midpoint conditions. We use one for all. Okay, let the vertices. D, P, A, comma B. Okay, A, D or point N at through A, comma B at through. Since B, D, C, G. B, D, C, G. B, D, C, G is a parallelogram. Is a parallelogram. BDCG is a parallelogram. So what is the condition? If it is a parallelogram, midpoint of the diagonals are equal. Okay, midpoint of BC is equal to midpoint of DG. Midpoint of BC is equal to midpoint of DG. Okay. So what is our B point? Here B point is minus 2 comma minus 1 and C point is 5 comma 3. Okay, then G D point is, we don't know, that is A comma B. Then G point is 2 comma 2. Okay, so we know that the midpoint formula, that is x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay, so you can take it, this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. The same as here also, x1 y1, x2 y2. Okay, so you can apply it. What do you get? Minus 2 plus 5 by 2 comma minus 1 plus 3 by 2. Then here A plus 2 by 2 comma B plus 2 by 2. Okay, so what do you get? Minus 2 plus 5, you will get 3. So 3 by 2. Then here minus 1 plus 3, you will get 2. So 2 by 2. Then this side, the same terms will come. Okay, so here 3 by 2, then 2 to cancel, we get 1. So 3 by 2 comma 1 is equal to A plus 2 by 2 comma B plus 2 by 2. Okay, so now we have to compare. What is that? The coordinate, first coordinate is A plus 2 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2. Okay, 2 to cancel. So A plus 2 is equal to 3. So A is equal to 3 minus 2. Therefore A is equal to 1. Okay. Then another point. B plus 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So B plus 2 is equal to A cross multiplication. So that is equal to 2. So B is equal to plus 2. This is becomes minus 2. So B is equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, the vertices, D is 1 comma 0. Okay. That's all. Then, last problem. If 3 by 2 comma 5, then 7 comma minus 9 by 2 and 13 by 2 comma minus 13 by 2 are the midpoints of the sides of the triangle. Okay, this is question number 7. Midpoints of the triangles. Okay, so first you can draw a triangle. Triangles are the sides or the midpoints. Okay, vertex. So what is that? First you can take the A vertex is x1 comma y1. And B vertex is x2 comma y2. Then C vertex is x3 comma y3. Okay. Then midpoints of the sides. Okay. So you can take it. This is the first point. You can take P. Okay. Any point you can give it. 3 by 2 comma 5. Then another point, Q, that is 7 comma minus 9 by 2. Then R, R point is 13 by 2 comma minus 13 by 2. Okay. So what do you want to prove? Find the centroid of the triangle. Centroid we want to find. Okay. Centroid find out. Enna pannanum first number. Three vertex or points in the centroid find out. So first vertex can be given already the method use. Okay, midpoints the method exercise use the same way here also you are going to do. Okay, take it in triangle ABC. Let A of x1 comma y1 and B of x2 comma y2 and C of x3 comma y3. Okay. The midpoint of a line. Formula. Midpoint of a line. Midpoint of a line is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by
2. Okay.
So this is the midpoint formula. So first AB oda midpoint find out panna porom. Okay. Midpoint of AB. Midpoint of AB is equal to P of 3 by 2 comma 5. Okay. Wa? So pa AB oda midpoint eppadi irundhala x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2 because AB points A point is x1 comma y1 and B point is x2 comma y2. Okay, so you can take it this is 3 by 2 comma 5. Okay, then you have to compare. What do you get? X1 plus x2 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2. Okay, 2 to cancel. So what do you get? X1 plus x2 is equal to 3. This is equation number 1. Okay. Then next one. Y1 plus y2 by 2 is equal to 5. Okay. Take cross multiplication. So you will get y1 plus y2 is equal to 10. This is equation number 2. Okay. Then another midpoint. Midpoint of BC. Midpoint of BC is equal to 7 comma minus 9 by 2. Okay. So B point is x2 comma y2 and the C point is x3 comma y3. So you can take it x2 plus x3 by 2 comma y2 plus y3 by 3. Sorry, by 2. By 2, okay, is equal to 7 comma minus 9 by 2. Okay, so then you can take comparison x2 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 7. That implies take cross multiplication. So what do you get? X2 plus x3 is equal to 14. This is equation number 3. Okay, then y2 plus y3 by 2 is equal to minus 9 by 2. Okay, 2 to cancel. That implies y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 9. This is equation number 4. Okay, then another midpoint. Midpoint of CA or AC. Okay, midpoint of AC is equal to, that is midpoint of AC is what, 13 by 2 comma minus 13 by 2. Okay, therefore A point is x1, x1 y1 and C point is x3 y3. So can take it x1 plus x3 by 2 comma y1 plus y3 by 2, that is equal to 13 by 2 comma minus 13 by 2. Okay, then take comparison. What do you get? X1 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 13 by 2. 2 to get cancelled. So x1, sorry, that is equal to x1 plus x3 is equal to 13. This is equation number 5. Okay, then y1 plus y3 by 2 is equal to minus 13 by 2. That implies 2 to cancel. Okay, therefore y1 plus y3 is equal to minus 13. This is equation number 6. Okay, so next the usual procedure. You have to add equation number 1, 3, 5. Okay. 1 plus 3 plus 5. You will get 2x1. Left hand side, if you add, you will get 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 2x3 is equal to the right hand side values 3, 3 plus 14 plus 13. Okay. So, if you add, you will get 14, 13, 27, 30. Okay, so you will get 30. So therefore, so what is that? X1 plus X2 plus X3 is equal to 30 divided by 2. Okay, wow. You get cancel. What is that? X1 plus X2 plus X3 is equal to 15. Okay. Okay, so x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equal to 15. Okay, so this is our equation number 7. Okay, this is our equation number 7. Then now you can apply substitute equation 1 in 7. So what is our equation 1? X1 plus X2 is equal to 3. So 3 plus X3 is equal to 15. That implies X3 is equal to 15 minus 3 is equal to 12. Okay, wow. Suppose you vertex k comma direct a very centroid matume ketundanga appadina nam enna panikalam direct a the x1 plus x2 plus x3 and the value direct a 3 ala divide panni nam answers find out panikalam. Okay, wow. But ஆனா சப்போஸ் சம்டைம்ஸ் கொஸ்டின்ஸ்ல வெர்டெக்ஸ் கேட்டிருந்தாங்க அப்படின்னா வெர்டெக்ஸ் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டு x1 x2 x3 ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டு தென் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஃபைண்ட் த சென்ட்ராய்ட். ஓகேவா? ஸோ அதனால என்ன பண்ணிருக்கேன், டேரக்டா இங்கே x3 இதோட ஆன்சர்ல அப்படியே 7 ஈக்குவேஷனை 3 ஆல டிவைட் பண்ணாலே x3 சென்ட்ராய்டோட பாயிண்ட் கிடைச்சிடும். பட் இருந்தாலும் நான் எதுக்காக ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணலாம், சப்போஸ் வெர்டெக்ஸ் கேட்டிருந்தாங்கன்னா என்ன பண்றது, அதுக்காக நான் இந்த வெர்டெக்ஸை ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டு தென் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஃபைண்ட் த சென்ட்ராய்ட். ஓகேவா? ஸோ ஹியர் x3 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 12. Okay, so x3 is equal to 12. Then equation number 3 implies, what is the equation number 3? X2 plus x3 is equal to 14. Okay, so x2 plus x3 is equal to 12. Okay, therefore x2 is equal to 14 minus 12, you will get 2. X2 is equal to 2. Then next one, equation number 5. Anyone you can choose, first equation also you can choose, no problem. Okay, your wish. So x1 plus x3 is equal to 13. Okay. So x1, we don't know. x3 is 12. So 12 is equal to 13. Therefore, x1 is equal to 13 minus 12. You will get x1 is equal to 1. Okay, therefore the points of x1, x2, x3. Okay, x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 2, and x3 is equal to 12. Okay, so like this you have to find y value also. Okay, so for that, for finding y values, you have to add equation number 2 plus 4 plus 6. Okay. So if you add, you will get left hand side 2y1 plus 2y2 plus 2y3. Okay, that is equal to right hand side minus 9. Then, sorry, first minus 10. Okay, minus 10, minus 9, then minus 13. Okay, so what do you get? Minus 13, minus 9, you will get minus 22. Minus 22 plus 10, you will get minus 12. Okay. Here, you will get the same term. So, what do you get remaining? If you take 2 outside, what do you get? y1 plus y2 plus y3. Okay. Therefore, y1 plus y2 value is y1 plus y2 plus y3. Is equal to minus 12 divided by 2, you will get minus 6. Okay, so this is equation number 8. y2 plus y3 is equal to 6. This is equation number 8. Okay, then substitute equation number 2.
substitute equation number 2. So what do you get? Substitute 2 in equation number 8, you will get y1 plus y2 is equal to here 10. So 10 plus y3 is equal to minus 6. Okay, therefore y3 is equal to minus 6 minus 10. So y3 is equal to minus 16. Okay, then fourth equation is y2 plus y3. y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 9. So y2 we don't know. y3 is minus 16 is equal to minus 9. Therefore y2 is equal to minus 9 plus 16. You will get 7. So y2 is equal to 7. Okay. Then another equation. Equation number 6. Equation number 6 implies y1 plus y3 is equal to minus 13. Okay. So y1 plus y3 is minus 16. So minus 16 is equal to minus 13. Therefore, y1 is equal to minus 13 plus 16. So y1 is equal to plus 3. Okay. So the points are, therefore y1 is equal to 3 and y2 is equal to 7, then y3 is equal to minus 16. Okay. Therefore the vertices are, A point is 1, 3 and B point is 2, 7, then C point is 12, minus 16. Okay. So now you want to find the centroid. Okay. Centroid formula is, what is that? x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Okay. So what is that? x1 is 1, x2 is 2 and x3 is 12 divided by 3. Okay. Then y1 is 3, y2 is 7, then y3 is minus 16 by n 3. Okay. So what do you get? 3 plus 12, 15 by 3. Then here you will get minus 6 by 3. So if we get cancel, you will get 5, here 2. Okay. So therefore g of x, y centroid is 5, minus 2. Okay. Therefore the centroid of a triangle ABC is 5, minus 2. Okay. Thank you students, your exercise 5.5 over as well as the chapter 5 also over. Okay. Thank you children.